You know that genotype impacts phenotype, but whose genotype impacts the phenotype? Hi, biology friends. It's Sarah, your other biology professor, and let's talk about genetic maternal effect. By now, I am sure you're familiar with the idea of the egg and its DNA reflecting the maternal genotype, combining with sperm and its DNA reflecting the paternal genotype to create an offspring with its own genotype. And with that offspring's genotype, the alleles that that offspring carries can interact with each other, dominant recessive, or with alleles at other loci in the organism's genome, or with the environment, in order to create the organism's phenotype. With genetic maternal effects, certain genes, called maternal effect genes, are expressed in the maternal germline. These are the cells that will divide by meiosis to make eggs. And the products of these genes, maybe RNA, maybe protein, will be deposited into what will become the egg cell. Mom has spiked the egg cytoplasm with products that her genes made. And after fertilization, those products will impact the earliest stages of development, including certain offspring phenotypes. And here, the instructions are coming from the maternal genotype, not the offspring. You may also run into environmental maternal effects, where different aspects of the maternal environment can impact the offspring's phenotype. But we're going to stick with the genetic effects here. This is one of those things that makes a little bit more sense with an example, and the classic one? Snails, of course. In many land snails, the shell can coil to the left or to the right. And your class may be using the terms sinistral and dextral instead of left and right. I'll leave up a little key here. The right coiling allele is dominant here. So we'll use big R for the right coiling allele, little r for the left coiling allele. Crossing a female right coiling snail to a male left coiling snail results in offspring that are all right coiling. And you're probably thinking, okay, that's fine. They're heterozygous and you already told me that right's dominant. Not a problem. But if you do the reciprocal cross, so take a female left coiling cross to a male right coiling, all the offspring are left coiling. But wait a minute, they're all still heterozygous. They have the same genotype as in the other cross, but the phenotypes are totally different. What is happening? The direction of coiling isn't determined by an individual's genotype, but by their mother's genotype. It's a genetic maternal effect. Before those baby snails ever existed, the mother snail's DNA, her alleles for coiling, were expressed and deposited product into the egg cells. And that product then controlled how the cytoplasm divided after fertilization. And that determines coiling. So a mother snail with a right coiling genotype deposits right coiling substance in the egg. All the offspring are right coiling, regardless of their genotype. Mother with a left coiling genotype deposits left coiling substance in the egg, and all the offspring are left coiling, regardless of their genotypes. Starting to make sense? Stay here. Let's look at the F2s. To get the F2s, we're going to cross two of these heterozygous left coiling snails together. And what genotypes would we expect to see? Well, a 1:2:1 ratio, right? And the phenotypes? All right coiling. Why? Don't they have to match mom? Well, mom's phenotype is left coiling, but her genotype is right coiling. Remember, it's all about mom's genes, right? Her phenotype was left coiling because her mom's genotype was left coiling. But her genotype is a right coiling genotype, which means she's going to put right coiling baby substance into all her eggs, and all of her offspring will be right coiling. 3/4 of our F2 females have a right coiling genotype, and 1/4 of our F2 females have a left coiling genotype. So if we bred F2 females with F2 males in order to create an F3 generation, what phenotypes would you expect to see in those offspring? Pause the video to think about it if you need a second. The genotypes of the F2 females will be reflected in the phenotypes of the F3 offspring. So 3/4 of our females had right coiling genotypes. They're going to deposit right coiling substance in those eggs, creating right coiling offspring. The other one quarter with left coiling genotypes will deposit left coiling products in those eggs and create left coiling offspring. As a quick note here, genetic maternal effect often gets mixed up with cytoplasmic inheritance, like mitochondrial inheritance, where everything's running through the maternal line. But here, the male parent does get to contribute to future generations. He contributes to his daughter's genotype, and while that's not seen in her phenotype that she expresses, it will be seen in the phenotypes of her future offspring. With genetic maternal effect, remember, what's the key to the offspring's phenotype? Not the offspring's genotype, and not the maternal phenotype, but the maternal genotype, mom's alleles. Give me a thumbs up if you learned something cool about snails. Sentence I never thought I'd say. Stick around and subscribe for more biology content from me to pass those exams. Check out my website for tutoring resources, and I will see you next time. Bye.